This is a presentation on double entry accounting. The basis of record keeping in accounting is that every transaction affects at least two accounts. Let's take an example of a store where a customer comes in and spends $100. It's easy to see that cash was received, but revenue was affected as well. At the end of the day, for example, the store owner will want to know the store sales for the day. And for the sales were paid for in cash, the store owner would expect that the cash in the cash register would equal the sales for the day. Let's write a journal entry for the $100 transaction. We would debit cash for $100 and credit sales for $100. Double entry accounting is the basis of the journal entry and keeps the journal entry balanced. Let's take another example of a business that needs cash and goes to a bank. The bank approves the loan and provides the cash. But that's only one side of the transaction. The other side is that the business has a liability. That is, it has an obligation to pay back the bank. In the journal entry, we would debit the account cash and credit the account bank loan payable. And remember that cash may not be involved in a transaction. For example, many businesses have telephone expenses that they pay for after the telephone was used. The business has an expense, but it also owes the telephone company as well. In this case, we would debit telephone expense and credit accrued expenses. And remember that there may be more than two accounts. Take an example of a computer repair shop that typically also sells merchandise. A customer comes in to pick up her repaired computer and buy some computer accessories as well. The computer repairman charges her $200 for fixing her computer and adds $100 for the computer accessories. The customer pays $300 in cash. When preparing the journal entry, we would debit cash and credit both sales and repair fee revenue. Always remember that every journal entry requires at least two accounts. This will keep your journal entries balanced and will enable you to carry over the numbers all the way through to your financial statements. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching.